Hey everyone, welcome back to another video. I can't believe we got something new about Ghostbusters Afterlife, and I'm gonna break this trailer down because, not trailer, clip down, because I just feel like I just want to, and I need an excuse to do a Ghostbusters related video. Whenever I get the chance, I just take that chance as much as I can. So let's get into it. So this trailer, let me just say my thoughts on it. I love it. I hope the movie is just like this. This dark humor of the mini puffs is what they're calling it. It's just amazing of like one of them impaling themselves, one of them making a s'more, one of them melting. Like, I so hope that the humor in this is exactly like this for these. Like, that's just amazing. Like, I didn't laugh, but like, again, I like how it's a little dark, and I love, and I hope that this movie can stay like this. So anyways, let's talk more about this. So we did know that the Mini Puffs were a character for a little while now. We've been kind of leaks have been happening of like a Funko Pop, I think, and then then cereal. Just like just today, right before the clip even came out, I saw on Facebook that someone who worked at Kroger found a cereal box for Ghostbusters Afterlife, and it had the Mini Puffs on them. And I think maybe this is why the clip was released, was due to the Mini Puffs being kind of put onto cereal boxes and all that, so they had to go ahead and give us an explanation why there is a weird-looking, tiny Stay Puff on cereal boxes, or all that sort of merchandise stuff, so start selling it. My thoughts, I really like it. This does seem like it is a different version of what we got from the game, because in the 2009 video game, the first game ever played, or one of the first games I ever played, in that exact game, there's a some levels of Stay Puft, and he throws these little mini marshmallow dudes that are like dog creatures that will come after you and try to kill you. I'm guessing this is where the trailer got, or not trailer, but the movie got inspiration from, but changed it a lot to these more Stay Puft-like creatures instead of a dog creature. I would say I prefer the design of the marshmallow minis, is what they call in the game. I think it's so cool, and I would love to see something live action, but again, I understand they're going to be trying to be a little more original, so I love the idea of it. But back to the breakdown, this little packaging that the the mini puff comes out of is the exact same packaging we got from the original movie. So, still same packaging. It's just kind of weird that after, you know, so much is going on, that Stay Puft is still Stay Puft Marshmallows is such a, is still selling marshmallows after the Stay Puft accident in New York. So that's really random, but oh well, who cares? I guess maybe they got more money from it because people wanted to buy more. I don't know. I don't get it. But oh well. It's such a funny idea. Not a funny idea, but just a random idea that maybe their business boomed even more after the accident. Probably. Probably a bunch of kids trying to recreate Stay Puft, maybe. I don't know. Kids are kind of weird. Another reference, I don't know if it's a coincidence or an actual reference, but when Paul Rudd's character, Mr. Gruberson, I'm sorry if I butchered that name, is picking up some ice cream, there's some Baskin-Robbins ice cream, and I think any Marvel fan is knowing where I'm going with this. If you don't know, everyone knows this. Paul Rudd plays Ant-Man, and in the first Ant-Man, Ant-Man works at Baskin-Robbins, and we get the most iconic line from one of the most funniest lines in Marvel. I forgot what it was, but it was like, Baskin-Robbins always knows, and I'm guessing maybe this could be a reference to that, but I could be wrong. There's Baskin-Robbins ice cream that might be a reference, or just a coincidence of, you know, an actor from another movie. But yeah, and that's kind of, and also, can we talk about that music? Oh, that music was amazing.
Jamocha.
If you don't know what I mean, in the original movie, the movie was composed by Elmer Bernstein. Sorry if I butchered that name again. And he made an amazing score for that first movie. Sadly, he didn't jump on to the second movie, but or they got someone else. I forgot. But and this one of the composers is actually his son or somehow related to him. I totally forgot how they were related, but I know that they are in the same bloodline of family. I think it's a son, but I don't want to say that and be wrong. So I'll just say that they're in the same family. So that's kind of cool that we have the son of the first movie's director and the son of the first movie's composer. So that is such a great, like, this is such a movie that is, like, that brings a message of putting the passing the torch down. I can't wait for this movie. I so hope it comes out this year. I feel like it is. With all the clip being released, I think we're nearing a new trailer, and I feel like they're confident for that November release. Or at least a this year, this release. I would love if they can push it earlier, but oh well, I'm okay. I really like when the sort of, I don't want to call this one a scary movie, but more like, I love it when more serious and maybe scary movies like this one release during those sort of fall time of October, November, because it just makes a lot more sense. So I'm glad we got a November release. I really wish we went with July or June release, because it just fits in with how the first two movies were released and their release dates. But oh well, it's, you know, that's okay. At least I can see it in theaters, and I hope I can see it in theaters. I wouldn't mind a streaming service, but theaters, I feel like it's going to be a lot better to see this movie. Anyways, guys, I'm going to go. Sorry for the short little video. I just had to break this clip down. Anyway, guys, I hope you guys enjoy this. Are you guys excited for the new movie? Do you think it's going to be better than the reboot? And do you think this is better than Ghostbusters 2? Anyways, goodbye.